Hello. Today I'd like to show you a tutorial about the basic steps you use to determine what a truck is allowed to weigh. Allowed weight is dependent on the following factors: axle type, axle rating, tire width, tire load rating, the number of wheels on an axle, the number of axles, and the distance between the axles, which is also called the bridge. There are several axle types: steering axles, tandem axles, lift axles, which are also called pushers, tritium axles, quad axles, and booster axles. Axle rating. The axle rating can generally be found on the VIN plate on the vehicle. Tire width. The tire width can be found on the tire sidewall. The width can be in inches or millimeters. The tire weight rating can be found on the tire sidewall as well. The number of wheels on an axle. For example, each of these two axles has four wheels on it. Number of axles is the number of total axles on the vehicle or within the bridge. The bridge distance is the distance measured from the center of axle to center of axle. Regulations. Weight regulations are imposed by federal and state jurisdictions. Each of these jurisdictions may have different regulations, which include different exemptions that are applied to certain types of vehicles, loads, and roads. Application of the regulations can be complicated. It is the operator's responsibility to know the regulations in the jurisdiction they operate. The Federal Bridge Formula. The Federal Bridge Formula is the foundation upon which most weight regulations are built. The W in the formula is the resulting allowed weight for the bridge. L is the length of the bridge, and N is the number of axles within the bridge. Please note, jurisdictions may use a different formula or chart. Number of axles. This is an example of how the number of axles is applied to the formula. Please note that the formula cannot be completed without the bridge length, L. The allowed weight of a truck is found by applying the jurisdiction's regulations to each of the following factors. The results are then compared with each other to find the lowest, or most limiting, which is the weight the truck is allowed to weigh: axle type, axle rating, tire width, tire load rating, the number of tires or wheels on an axle, the number of axles, and the distance between the axles, also called the bridge. Please note, there can be many bridges within a truck. The allowed weight must be computed for each one. Axle type allowance. On the federal interstate highways, and generally most states, the allowance on an axle is 20,000 pounds. However, each axle type may be required to follow different regulations depending on the jurisdiction in which a truck is operated. Axle rating allowance. Each jurisdiction may have different regulations regarding how the axle rating is used to determine the allowed weight. For example, on the federal interstate system, the steering axle may carry 20,000 pounds or the steering axle rating, whichever is less. Each state may apply axle rating differently on state roads. Tire width and number of wheels on an axle. Tires are limited in most jurisdictions by the amount of weight they can carry per inch of tire width. The tire width is taken directly off the tire. Allowances are varied and generally range from 450 pounds to 650 pounds per inch of tire width. For example, with two tires or wheels that are 11 inches wide and are allowed by the jurisdiction to carry 650 pounds per inch of width. You take 650 pounds times 11, which equals 7,150 pounds. You then take two tires times 7,150 pounds, and the result is 14,300 pounds. Therefore, the axle allowance by tire width for the axle is 14,300 pounds. Tire rating and number of wheels on an axle. Tires are limited in some jurisdictions by the amount of weight they can carry per the tire rating. The tire rating is taken directly off the tire. The allowance is computed much the same as the tire width is computed. An example of an axle with two tires, or wheels, and each tire is rated for 6,175 pounds. You take 6,175 times two tires, which equals 12,350 pounds. Therefore, the axle allowance by tire rating for the axle is 12,350 pounds. Distance between the axles, also called the bridge. In this example, we've measured from axle 1 to axle 2. The measurement is 18 feet 1 inch. If the inches are 6 or greater, we round to the next foot. In this example, the inches are 1, so we round down to 18 feet. We find the total allowance by comparing axle, tire, and bridge allowances. Step 1 is to find the axle type allowance. For axle 1, it's 20,000 pounds. For axle 2, it's 20,000 pounds. In step 2, we find the tire width allowance. For axle 1, it's 14,300 pounds. For axle 2, it's 28,600 pounds, because there's four tires on that axle. In step 3, we compare the tire and the axle allowances and take the least. For axle 1, it's 14,300 pounds. For axle 2, it's 20,000 pounds. In step 4, we add the bridge, tire, and axle allowances. In this example, we're doing from bridge 1 to bridge 2. So we add those allowances. The result is 34,300 pounds. In step 5, we find the bridge allowance using the federal bridge formula. We simply plug in the number of axles and the distance between them. The result is 48,000 pounds. In step 6, we select the lowest weight from step 4 and step 5. This is the allowed weight of the bridge. This example is for axle 1 to axle 2, using the federal bridge formula, not on the interstate. The 650 pound per inch tire allowance is for illustration only, and not per any specific jurisdiction's regulation. We complete finding what the truck is allowed to haul by doing the 6 steps for each bridge within the truck. The result is the allowed weight. Appreciate you viewing this tutorial. We hope it's been a help to you. If you have any comments or questions, please email us. Thank you again, and have a great day.